Well, boys, I'm back in Red Flood. Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4 with me, Mountain General. The only guy from Slovakia you will ever know. At least most of you, I assume. And finally, after a long time and a lot of comments, I'm back in Red Flood. It just took me from December to get here. And yeah, the mod got some new updates, and I have to say, it's a very based mod from what I have seen. So tell me in the comments what countries you want to see me cover. So thank you for the comments for those sweet, sweet engagement points. And if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, because we are aiming for 50,000 subscribers so I can play Banat at 50k. And also, follow me on Twitter and join the Discord server, check out the links in the description. And yeah, after shameless social media plug, we can go back to gaming. And you know, I am a true gamer, so I won't be playing here in Europe. I'm going to Africa. Bongo bongo, we are going to Congo. Leopold, what the fuck did you do? But now, today we will be playing as the Prussian Congo, and we will destroy the Belgians. So yeah, we are right away thrown into the arena that is called the Congo now. And well, our nation is the Prussian Congo. I don't know how the Germans got here or anything, but I know that we are Congo and we are here to win this bloody civil war. Which will be a little problem when I have only 70 people that I can recruit to my under-equipped army, but at least they are trained like a motherfucking veterans. And also, we are the most developed African country, we have 3 research slots. That almost seems impossible. And also, Mr. Ernest Junger has to decide the fate of our country, and then we will be able to crack down the fake Congos and reunite the whole Congo as Prussia. And I got to say, I really love the flags here, what they do, and overall the art style of Red Flood. I love it so much. If it doesn't burn your eyes, then it's a good UI. And also, we have something here called annexation events, and you know what, I won't be fucking with this. I feel like playing Prussian Congo is messing with the world enough. You know what, I got to say, I really love the weirdness of this mod, like socialist Goebbels, that's a thing. And also, a British Japanese guy rose up in Japan. Soccer stadium opens in Equatostad. Please call it like a normal person. A football. I got to say, this world is pretty spicy with those leftist revolutions. My world's on fire. How about yours? I mean, even our IRL world is on fire. Oh, who doesn't love the civil wars in Asia? Am I right, boys? And now, back to our country, we have to decide our future. And well, we have to go with Mr. Hans Hutting if we want to have some factories. Yeah, because we need those guns. Ooh, I didn't know we were role-playing as the Belgians. Oops, I clicked it. Well, as the France bullies the southern Belgian in Europe, I will one day bully the Congolese Belgian here. And now we can also create Lebensborn. I thought we were creating here the Congolese Lebensraum. I don't know why, but I really love the chaos of the world here. War is everywhere. But I'm just chilling in Prussian Congo. And also, this is where the pain begins. Very nice. Damn, the Uganda looks strong. They were even able to encircle the British here. Here, bro, have my 10 support equipment. And the dreams of free Uganda are dead. I got to say, it's only 1937 and the world is getting spicier and spicier. Whoa, slow down there, buddy. You are creating a disgusting riot. You know, spreading too thinly will fuck you in ass, bro. But who am I here to judge? I'm going to destroy the Republic of the Southern Congo here. And would you look at that, The Hobbit was published. Too bad, it's too long for me. I will just wait for the film. And now, no question asked. We are going into Southern Congo. Oh no, why did 14 divisions just spawn there? Now this will be a bigger problem. Now we just have to push on. But yeah, at least here we have a nice little encirclement. Now basically what you want to do is to retreat here and wait for them to attack. And then reinforce and kill as many of your enemies as you can. But also you can make them leave their capital city undefended. Big brain moves, if you ask me. Yeah, unfortunately they were able to reinforce their capital city, but now we will try to overrun this army here. I mean, it's working perfectly here in the south. Hey, would you look at that? Few tricks later and their capital city is cut from their... rest of country, it's not much, but it's an honest encirclement. And yeah, this is what everyone wants to see. Now our crazy Congolese ride doesn't stop here. And yeah, we gain the seaport, and our country will be more developed than ever before. Now, from the last war I learned that we have to rush their capital city no matter the cost. And yeah, this war will be much easier than the one before. Yeah, it's nicely over for them. Not very surprising result. Now I am the liberator of Congo. It's time to crush the Belgians. As the Germans bullied the Belgians in Europe, I shall do that too in Africa. Yeah, nothing matches the Prussian Congo. Yeah, we even have tanks. A little division, but very effective in Congolese jungle. Now that's a lot of artillery for good. Now I feel like Kivu will be our greatest enemy. They have up to 57 divisions. Now let's end Mr. Protector for good. And now this is the first war where I'm slightly worried, but... oh well, let's see how this will go down. Now slowly we will push in, but... yeah, this will be a bloody conflict. I see that Europe is also on fire. Just like the Congo. So basically to win this war I had to sacrifice a lot of people. So yeah, two words. Not worth it. But now, the Congo was unified by Prussia. Very nice, and now we can develop our country. So we can have some economy. I mean, this is a very nice event. Now we can just chill and speak German. And also we have a nice super event of Congolese reunification. Nice, the Germans defeated the French. And Armenians got the Algeria. How? Don't ask me. Now we also have to decide the fate of Congo, and I think the Mr. Junger is the best choice for this country if you want to stay in the Prussian Congo. Oh no, the Germany is at war with Germany. I should somehow get involved. I wasn't able to send my one volunteer there quickly enough. F's in the chat, boys. Maybe I wasn't able to help with Prussia, but one man's Germany is the other man's Africa, as we say it here in Congo, or something like that. I will liberate the Germany from the Red Terror. But before we go to Europe, we need to stop here in Brazil. Yes, I am the best Brazil fighter. Ah yes, São Salvador will be mine. Ah yes, I too remember a time when Congolese Prussians went to France to liberate it from German oppression. Very great timeline. I mean, the Germans did it again. They have too many enemies to worry about. Yeah, they are no match for my Congolese super fighters. I feel like the Germans are overpowered as fuck. They are just overrunning everything that comes into their way. And well, I got to say, the late game is not very fun. But I'm doing it to myself, so... and yeah, bye-bye Poland, you will be overrun. And yeah, bye-bye Netherlands. But the Brazilian campaign is going pretty well, I would say. But I got to say, I think I found myself a nice warm place where the Germans are unable to push. For now. The European situation is pretty shit. But on the other hand, the Brazilian situation is very good. Congolese fighters were made for Brazil. You know, I fucking hate when capitulating the country takes so fucking long. Like, Brazil, you have nothing, just capitulate already. So many brain cells lost. I gotta say, the war with the Germany wasn't worth it. Or was it? Look at my new empire. And yeah, I know the borders are not looking that good, because the peace deals are very, very strange. But I have a state transfer tool here with me to fix some shit up. So yeah, I played around little with the state transfer tool, and I have made my borders look decent. And also I have made some puppets, but apparently it is a big no-no and do it on your risk, but I did it anyway, also with the Commonwealth nations. UK has some puppets, and USA too. So I got to say that Gross Kongolisches Reich is looking pretty good. And yeah, I got to say that I really enjoyed Red Flood, and I will definitely play more nations here. And as always, big thanks goes to my channel members, their names are in the description and on the screen right now. And a special thanks goes to Lazuli, Mongolicios and Potato Boy for being the highest channel members. Like the video or you are going to Congolese Brazil.